What's up, everybody? This is Carrick with ACG, the Bearded Shaman of Gaming, bringing you guys reviews at the speed of embargo. Recently, I was asked to give my thoughts on Batman, the first in the new Telltales episode and series. And honestly, I'm mobile today. So what I did is I found a little quiet place, that somewhat quiet place, that I could record and give you guys my thoughts on it. I did complete it twice, once on the Xbox One and now on the PC, and sort of my thoughts about it. Now, this is going to be a very short review. And one of those reasons why is, let's be honest, the Telltale engine pretty much always looks the same and sounds the same, but it's those different assets within it that sort of matter. So I'm just going to walk you down through a couple of the different categories, my overall thoughts. And I have to say, graphically, I was actually pretty impressed with it. There were some issues with some low-res textures here and there. And, you know, it's always one of those times when you look at the characters and it looks like all of the details have sort of been Hoover vacuumed off the faces of all the main characters. But overall, I would say it was pretty good. The animation still is wanting. I think these titles, that's just the way it's going to be. Now, let's just do a quick listen of some sound music and voice from the game.
Pause. Mr. Wayne, I'd like to introduce you to Bob and Regina Zellerbach. Of course I know these two.
Hello, Bruce.
Regina here is the chairwoman of Wayne Enterprises, and her husband
voted for Mayor Hill last time. I'll admit it, Mr. Wayne. I don't know Mr. Dent from a pothole on Main Street, but I trust your family.
Without a scratch.
So far.
Now, when it comes to music, this is fantastic. It's got all the Batman themes, and it's just that charging violins where you just consistently wonder if Batman should be on a horse riding with Conan beside him. And I really, really dug it. I absolutely love the themes that are in Batman, that heavy violin and just all of the hero horns going on. So that was really well done. Now, when it comes to sound, you know, sometimes we get games where the sound in the Telltale games is actually a little bit muffled, a little bit truncated. It depends on how they record them. And, you know, they're using the same Foley work, but when it comes down to it, there are little differences in the way the graphics represent the overall landscape and place. And then when you get that Foley artist making their sound effects, sometimes things can seem a little off place. But actually, I was quite happy, especially when you look at the duality here, which I'm going to talk about in a second, of having both an action-packed main character with bombastic over-the-top scenes and special effects and his special little items that he uses consistently, and then the more sedate moments where you're actually Bruce Wayne. So I was pretty happy with the sound. And of course, voice. You know what? This is honestly really, really good voice. Commissioner Gordon, I'm not really a big fan of the interactions between Batman and him. I don't know what it was about that, but I wasn't really in love with the voice actor who does that guy. Batman's one of those games that has 100 different versions of all of these characters, so everybody can sort of identify with a very particular aspect of those different characters that they like when it comes to the voices, which is probably one of the major bits of this game. I would say I liked it, but I wasn't in love with a couple of them. So let's just talk about gameplay. There is that duality, which I spoke of. You start out as Batman, and you're actually really injected quite quickly into the Batman motif. So you're there, you're doing all your quick moves. And I noticed, and this may just be me, that the prompts for action was quite quick. And to me, of all the changes that we get in these games, this might be one of my favorites. It really did seem shorter. Now, if I'm wrong, that's great. But I mean, we all understand these are interactive comics. And the fact that you're sort of required to have more attention span while you're playing this versus the prior titles, I really, really liked. So then you jump into Bruce Wayne, and I have to say, I really liked some of the unique little bits there. It wasn't just the part where you were in the Batcave, but there's some sections that I thought were actually sort of cool, like the phone, where you're tweeting with Alfred, and you're making a choice. Do you want to pick up the phone and make the call, or do you want to just continue with what you're doing at the time? Additionally, Bruce Wayne has a lot more speaking moments, of course, than Batman, which was very cool, because you could really engage in this awesome ideal that Bruce Wayne has to deal with those two sides of the same coin when it comes to a character. And so what I liked about this was, not only were you engaging in the three typical question spectrum that we always see in Telltale games, you also had the fact that you were technically also Batman. And so you had to think on these multiple layers, which I really thought was engaging. So I'll just finish this up with my reviews or my impressions, whatever you want to call this. Basically, I really do think this is one of the most enjoyable ones, other than maybe The Wolf Among Us. I really had a fun time playing this. The duality is great there, in a way, probably like The Wolf Among Us, where you could basically be human and then sometimes turn into a werewolf. So that was very cool, and it might be why I am really enjoying this one. I also think they did a very good job separating the two lifestyles and having you engage in both of them, so you don't feel like one is too much overburdened by the other. that duality, I think, speaks highly to the morality system that's always in the Telltale games. And now you finally have a real difference where you have this character that's a secret alter ego plus your Bruce Wayne, and you're answering questions. And you sometimes have to think, how would you answer as both people? Which was really fantastic. So I would just say my impressions. Graphically, there were some issues. It's still stuttered. These games continually have that issue. But as I spoke at the starting about the engine, that's something that we normally see. So, you know, I rate these games on a buy, wait for sale, rent, or never touch it again rating scale. Of course, this kind of game, because it's episodic, is always different. I think I'll just say this. You know, I think that you could go with a try it now or wait until maybe more episodes are released. This is probably the most enjoyable single first episode of any of the Telltale games I've played. And that it also actually includes A Wolf Among Us. So that goes to show you how much I enjoyed it. And I am not necessarily a huge Batman fan. I do have some art and a couple posters here and there, but I don't follow the comics a ton. I follow them a little bit. I watch the movies, but I'm certainly not a diehard fan. But here, that momentary bit where you get to slow down a tiny bit. See, remember, when you're looking at the Arkham games, there's always speed involved. And even if you have the moments of detective, those little bits where everything slows down, it always feels like it's slowed down, but you're still moving as that character in full speed. This game does it a little bit differently because you have almost two different control styles. The one walking around control style where you're Bruce Wayne, and then the Batman fast, quick, you know, movements, the attacks, and that style. And it feels very cool because you actually feel slightly like two different characters, which strangely enough, in the more action-packed games, they never become sedate enough for that to happen. So I really enjoyed this title. I'm stoked to actually see the next one and really, really excited to see the continuation of this series. So anyway, that's it for me. I hope you can't hear the train in the background. I apologize for the noise. As always, peace out and thanks for watching.